When they passed away, the local decided, okay, what shall we do now? These people were great, it's part of our heritage now. So the local disputed what to do next with the burial. Some suggested making a building at the mouth of the cave as a memorial. Others suggested building a place of worship where their people could worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is exactly what happened. This is mentioned in the Quran itself, that the people there, they decided to build a masjid on the site. So you could say a mizar, a masjid was built on that. قَالَ الَّذِينَ غَلَبُوا عَلَىٰ أَمْرِهِمْ لَنَتَّخِذَنَّ عَلَيْهِمْ مَسْجِدًا. We will certainly take upon them a masjid, a place of worship where people can learn about this great story and can take barakah from this place. The Mufassirin have written that this verse indicates that to build mosques near the site of the deceased pious men is permissible. It is jayz, it is proven from the Quran. It has been a tradition of the Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah from the beginning of Islam, that when a pious person passes away, a wali or certainly a nabi from the Anbiya-i Kiram, then the Muslims, they build a mosque there, they build a mizar there where people can go there and in comfort and ease can recite the Quran, can pray there and as much as possible attain barakah, not to indulge in grave worship. There is no such thing as grave worship in Islam. We do not go for grave worship. We go there to attain the barakah that Allah has put there. Subhanallazi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa alladhi barakna hawlahu. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes al-masjid al-aqsa as a place which we have created barakah around it. It is a place which has blessings around it. Imam Qurtubi writes that the reason why there is barakah around this place is because thousands of prophets and messengers have been buried near, in and around Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. It's a fact that where a pious man passes away, that is where you find the barakah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, and I will mention them. I have no problem in mentioning them. There are countless ahadith in which the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam seemingly suggested that a masjid and a qabr do not go together. I will read some of them. There is a hadith in which our Prophet said, لا تصلوا إلى الكبور ولا تجلسوا عليها. Don't pray towards the graves, don't sit on them. اشتد غضب الله على قوم اتخذوا قبور أنبيائهم وصالحين مساجدا. The anger of Allah is most severe upon the people who take the graves of their prophets and pious people as mosques. In another hadith, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, لعنة الله على اليهود والنصارى. Allah, may Allah curse the Jews and the Christians. Why? اتخذوا قبور أنبيائهم مساجدا. They took the graves of their messengers as a place of sajda. What do these ahadith mean? Number one, it means praying towards the grave as if you are doing sajda towards them. That is what is mamnu. Never pray towards a qabr. This is mamnu. That is what is meant by these hadiths. Number two, our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is saying that as with the Christians did before, do not worship the being inside the grave. Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam is the Prophet of Allah, he is not the son of Allah. The Jews and Christians, read upon what they used to do. They used to worship their prophets. We don't worship our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, we respect him. Our Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is the servant, he is the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is not his son. Astaghfirullah wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-aliyyi al-azim. If people have a question, if people have a query about a mosque and a qabr being on the same site, then please think for yourself, and this is the most logical answer. Al-Masjid al-Nabawi alayhi salatu wa salam. Our Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam is buried in the Hujra Mubarakah of Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, which is part of the mosque now. Thousands upon thousands of people read salah there each and every day, since the beginning and inshallah ta'ala until the day of judgment. To conclude, some other facts about them. Their number, Allah does mention their number in the Quran. Seemingly, it seems that there were seven of them. That is the strongest opinion. Other people in the Quran, it's mentioned, سَيَكُولُونَ ثَلَاثَةُ رَابِعُهُمْ كَلْبُهُمْ. Some people thought it was three, the fourth being the dog. Some thought it was four, the fifth being the dog. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Allah knows best that number.